Forms which collect data from users are a critical touchpoint where we can either make it very easy or very difficult for people to use our designs. There's a lot of variability in how forms should be designed, depending on what type of information is being collected. But there are a few general principles about how you visually organize the fields that can go a long way towards making it easy for people to understand the form and avoid errors while completing it. First of all, make sure that the placement of the labels makes it completely obvious which label goes with which field. Labels should always be closer to the field they describe than they are to any other fields. Don't create ambiguity by showing a label that is equally distant to two different fields. Showing the labels inside the fields avoids this problem, but it also creates other problems because you need to use that space inside the field to show what the user has typed. And sometimes the users won't be able to see the field label if you've removed it to show their input. Second, most forms work better if you stick to a single column of fields and avoid the temptation to make the form shorter by squeezing multiple fields into a single row. Of course, there are exceptions to this, such as dates. A day, a month, and a year are actually three parts of the same piece of information, so it would be strange to divide them into three different rows. But for the most part, each field of the form is a separate question, and you should ask those questions one at a time with a clear single path through the form down one column. Using a single column reduces the risk that people will overlook fields that are off to the side. Finally, use spacing intentionally to communicate when you are switching to a different topic within the form. For example, if you first collect contact information and then ask about payment information, visually separate these two topics into different groups by adding extra space between them. Forms aren't exciting, but they are an important point of interaction, and one that, with a little forethought, you can make as easy and frictionless as possible.